Fritz Breithaupt cycles to work at Indiana University's Bloomington campus every day. The small city in the American heartland is a haven for bicycles in an otherwise car-dominated country. The university is known for its academic freedom and innovation, and Bloomington feels like an exception in arch-conservative Indiana. Breithaupt says the divisions in the country since the election are palpable here.
Every morning you look to see if there's a new tweet, another big news event. Some people are hopeful that something good will happen now that someone's finally put his foot down. But many others are waiting for a disaster to happen. So I'd say the basic mood is one of nervous anticipation.
Fritz Breithaupt teaches German literature, but he's also known for his work in cognitive science. He's interested in the way language, awareness, and thinking influence people's decisions. Lately, he's been focusing on the president.
What I notice about Trump is how he manages to win empathy for himself. He creates situations in which he pits himself against everyone else. He polarizes a situation and brings it to a head. And that's when people are able to identify with him. People wonder what they'd say in his position. Usually they can't say very much, but he can. He's glib. And then people empathize with him. They see things from his point of view and they stand by him. They go through thick and thin with him.
Professor Breithaupt draws attention to Trump's talking style that triggers emotion and draws people in. Simple words and short sentences are peppered with overblown generalizations, and they're short on concrete facts.
I don't think people really believe all he says, but he does attract empathy. He can whip up emotions in a flash. You want to know what he'll say next. He uses high-flying adjectives like terrific and amazing.
Breithaupt is convinced that Trump's core supporters will stick with him as long as he stays true to his principles, regardless how critical his opponents are. So the professor has little hope that the divisions in the U.S. will be healed during this presidency.
We have a two-party political system, Republicans and Democrats. And we have a media landscape that is also completely split. People live in their own social bubbles. They only see the messages from their own friends. I can't see what would really be able to bring them together.
Hardly bright prospects on that front, then. But for Fritz Breithaupt, at least, his second home is shaping up to be a fascinating subject to study for the foreseeable future.